I once plunged 300 feet face down at more than 90 miles an hour. And in those few seconds, I learned a lot. That was 3 years ago with my niece Alexis, who was 13 and thrilled that I'd agreed to go on a roller coaster with her. I still remember the drive. We were a few miles from the park when she shouted, "There it is, Leviathan." Well, I nearly crashed the car. This was not the roller coaster I remembered from my high school days. It turns out, Canada's Wonderland has spent $28 million building Canada's largest roller coaster, Leviathan, a biblical monster. And the closer we got to the gate, the more excited Alexis got, and the more petrified I became. And my niece sensed my fear. "But you said you weren't afraid of anything because God is always with you," she sneered. Busted by a teenager, there was no turning back. And they take your picture as you plunge. And it's one of my niece's favorite pictures. She's got her two hands in the air, her blonde ponytail is swinging, and she's laughing her head off. Where I am misery itself. I'm clinging to the rail, my hair is in spikes, and I am not just screaming, I'm actually crying, wailing, like that famous picture, The Scream. And when I look back at that image, I realize that Alexis and I experienced that journey very differently. I had allowed my fear to destroy the joy of the journey, and Alexis had the right approach. She had a joyful sense of adventure. And I decided I wanted to live like that. A lesson I remembered a year later when my life fell apart quite spectacularly, and I found myself once again plunging into the unknown. And I'm here to tell you all about it, to share 10 lessons I've learned on this journey, and to tell you that life is a pilgrimage, a journey with a purpose, in which you are not alone, so do not be afraid. And on this journey, it's taken me to the BBC, into a convent, out of the convent, and here onto St. Patrick's Way, where I'm a pilgrim guide in Downpatrick. And on this journey, I've laughed, I've loved, and I've lost. I have met triumph and disaster, and I have met some incredible people. And I have taken a few wrong turns, been distracted by seemingly delightful paths, and I've suffered. And like many a pilgrim, I've done my share of whining, whinging, and complaining, wondering sometimes what this journey was all about. And maybe like you, I have felt like giving up. But you know, I've always kept going. My faith has got me through every trial, knowing that God loves me and has an amazing plan for my life. And you know, my life hasn't been perfect. And sometimes I have found it really hard to walk with God. But I've learned it's impossible to walk without Him. And despite the challenges, my journey has been amazing. As a BBC political correspondent, I've journeyed to number 10 Downing Street, into Windsor Castle, and the White House. I was among the press corps who reported that the Good Friday Agreement had been signed after decades of violence here in Northern Ireland. I was in Oslo when our political leaders received the Nobel Peace Prize. And I was in the Oval Office at the White House when President George W. Bush met our first ministers, once sworn enemies. But better than that, I've danced in the rain at a Bruce Springsteen concert in Dublin, in the pit, a few feet from the boss. And 7 years ago, I walked away from everything, a career I'd spent years building, family, friends, concerts, because I found something better than being on TV talking about politics, better than Bruce Springsteen, better than anything I've ever experienced. And that brings me to lesson one of pilgrimage. Sometimes you gotta break new ground. Sometimes you have to take a risk to get the life you want. And I took an exquisite risk, and I found more joy and peace than I've ever known. But when I was considering this new path, I thought about it a lot. I prayed about it a lot. And that is lesson two of pilgrimage. Do the prep. Before you embark on a risky path, do the prep. Because I knew that even if I wanted to give up everything and follow Jesus, it was going to turn my life upside down. And it seemed impossible. And it was at that crossroads that I learned lesson three of pilgrimage, read the signs. And you know, I actually saw the writing on the wall. It was at a school I was visiting, a quote from St. Francis of Assisi, and it said, "First do what's necessary, then do what's possible, and the impossible will follow." Cosmic advice, and I took it. And you know, having read the signs, my experience of pilgrimage deepened, and I did the impossible. I became a sister of Adoration, Sister Martina of the Blessed Sacrament. And as an Adoration sister, I really loved this path. This path was full of beauty and goodness and truth. Yes, it had its thorns as well as roses, but I felt I had landed on Mount Tabor, convent speak for that place where you feel the love and glory of God. And I wanted to stay on Mount Tabor forever. But in the words of my novice director, you can't stay on Mount Tabor forever. So my convent journey took me to rocky patches, to choppy waters and still waters. And sometimes my convent journey took me to my least favorite place, Mount Molehill, a place of misery, where the petty problems of life are magnified, where you start to wallow in self-pity, and the whining begins. And believe me, it's not easy to get off Mount Molehill. It takes some effort. It takes you to take a look around and find a fellow pilgrim who's struggling with their pack and help them. Help them with their load. Because if you want to have a happy life, give of yourself. That is lesson 4. Give of yourself and receive joy and love. And that is journeying with a purpose. That's how you get back to Mount Tabor. And a wise person once said that angels travel lightly because they're self-forgetful. So give of yourself. But in giving of yourself and helping others carry the load, you can get pretty exhausted. And so that brings me to lesson 5. Find a place of refreshment, a pilgrim's rest. And for me, that place I call Elim. That's the place in the Old Testament where the Jews were wandering around in the desert and they found an oasis, Elim, a place of 12 springs and 70 palm trees, a place to be refreshed. And you know, if you take the time and to be refreshed in the beauty of God's creation, you will come alive again and you will feel the love. And that experience you're going to need because there's always trouble ahead on the road. And I found trouble ahead of the road when I got the shock of my life from the God of surprises. I, along with 3 other women, were told that we would have to leave the convent because the congregation had grown too small and fragile to complete our 9-year formation. And you know, I was devastated. Which brings me to lesson number 6. Suffering is part of the journey. Suffering cannot be escaped. Suffering is a mystery to be embraced. And it's still a mystery to me why I had to leave everything behind again, why at 3 p.m. on September 23rd, 2019, I was stripped of my habit, my way of life, my religious family, and the place I lived. But you know, in that mystery, I got a gift. There is always a gift in suffering. Suffering passes, and the gift I got was I learned to know myself better than ever, and I became stronger than I've ever been. And that's why on the pilgrim's path, St. Paul tells us to rejoice in our suffering, rejoice whatever the circumstances, because suffering leads to perseverance, and perseverance leads to character, and character leads to hope, and my hope is rooted in a God who loves me and has an amazing plan for my life. But I was in a lot of turmoil and pain, and I felt lost, and I didn't know what to do. So I did the only thing that any pilgrim can do on a journey. I consulted my route map. Lesson number 7, consult the route map. And as a Christian, my route map, my road map, is the inspired word of God, which is alive and active. And my road map told me that every inch of my pilgrimage was mapped out, and that I was at Calvary, a place the world calls disaster, a place we Christians call the cross, a place of suffering and death that leads to new life. And I knew I was going to suffer and I was going to die as an Adoration sister, but God would raise me to new life and he would bless a new path for me. And in that dark place, I learned another important lesson of pilgrimage. Lesson 8, do not go ahead of the guide. Stay in the present moment, taking a few steps at a time with the guide. Stay and wait patiently for the guide. Because when you go 100 miles down the road, you end up full of anxiety. And I had a very sleepless night in the convent. And normally I sleep like a baby, but this night I tossed and I turned. What will I do? Where will I go? How will I live? But by the next morning, I was back in the present moment, at peace with the guide, because I realized that my security doesn't lie in a bank account, which can be wiped out in a financial crisis. My security lies with the guide, the good, loving shepherd who is always with me. So I stayed in the present moment, remembering that the roadmap told me that God is always with me, holding me by the right hand, and he would never abandon me. And that is lesson number 9, do not be afraid. Because I remembered the last time I was really afraid, and it was on that roller coaster. And I remembered how I wanted to live. I wanted to live with a joyful sense of abandonment, trusting the guide. And so I waited with patience for the new path, and I waited for miracles to happen. And that is lesson number 10. Miracles do happen. For God, nothing is impossible. For God, nothing is impossible. It's even in the roadmap, Luke 1:37, for God, nothing is impossible. And a few days before I had to leave the convent, a friend offered me a place to live here in Downpatrick. And 6 months later, when I was ready to work, I got a mission with St. Patrick's Center. And you know, I even gave birth to a lockdown baby, St. Patrick's Way, a pilgrimage within a pilgrimage. And many people have come to walk with us, to be physically and spiritually challenged, and to come out in a better place. So keep going. Do not give up. You will come out in a better place. At the end of your journey, you will meet the guide. Life is a pilgrimage, a journey with a purpose in which you are not alone, so do not be afraid. Break new ground. Give of yourself. And wherever you are, enjoy the journey. God bless you.